I love to catch striped bass, but even more than that, I love to catch great big ones. That's exactly what we're gonna try to do on this week's episode, because we're taking you along with us to one of the best trophy striper lakes in the entire country. Crystal clear water, beautiful scenery, and a great day. What more could you ask? Come on along. Fox Sports Outdoors is on the air right now.
You're watching the only program with weekly fishing reports and real-time outdoor news from the Southwest region. This is Fox Sports Outdoors.
It's a calm, quiet, and peaceful morning in the mountains of Northwest Arkansas. This is beautiful Beaver Lake. It is 50 miles of the dammed up White River. It's 32,000 surface acres. And it was the home of the very first ever Bassmaster Classic fishing tournament many years ago. Today it's known as a little bit of a difficult bass fishery, but what you may not know is that it's one of America's premier striped bass fisheries. Some of the largest stripers caught in America are caught right here in Beaver Lake. You're going to want to stay with us for this entire episode, because Mike Bailey of Beaver Safari Guide Service is going to take us out. We're going to put the brand new Z19 high performance fishing boat in Beaver Lake for the first time. And we just may get to show you some of the biggest stripers we've ever showed you in the history of our television show. This is going to be a lot of fun. We'll be taking you around your local region for your fishing reports from your local lakes, rivers, and bays from our expert team of insider reporters as well. It's going to be an exciting half hour. Stay with us right now. Let's get it started back at the FSN studios with your weekend planner.
The Salooner tables are indicating fair game fish activity over both days of the weekend. Peak action should begin a little before sunrise in the mornings and again in advance of sunset in the evenings. Sunrise will take place at 7:15 with sunset occurring at 7:48. And evenings will feature a crescent moon that is 27% visible. Stay with us for regional fishing updates from around the area. And we'll talk crappie fishing on this week's Ask the Pro feature. Back in a bit.
Fox Sports Outdoors is brought to you by Tracker Boats. It's more than a boat, it's a tracker. Mercury Marine, go boldly. Lowrance Electronics, celebrating 60 years of fish finding excellence. Find, navigate, dominate. And Costa Sunglasses, see what's out there.
There he is right there. Look at this fish. Holy cow, what a pig. Hey everybody, glad to have you with us. We're out early morning and we've made it out on Beaver Lake. Crystal clear water. Look at this, Mike Bailey is already hooked up. Absolutely unbelievable. I mean, he barely made his first stop, got two lines in the water, and he's already got a fish. Wow, Mike, your early morning prediction was exactly right. Tell me, why is early important for these fish, Mike? What's the deal with the light level?
Well, it's all the light penetration. And traffic on the lake has a lot to do with it. They like to feed during that dim light hour, you know, first thing in the morning or late in the evening. Catch the bait when they're unaware. The bait's kind of near the surface. And then the stripers are looking up, you know, they're kind of prowling along behind them down below, watching for those silhouettes.
And it definitely gets tougher the brighter the day gets.
You'll have to start fishing deeper. On this clear water lake, the more sunlight penetration you got, definitely the harder the bite's gonna be.
This is really a trophy striper fishery. You don't catch a lot of little fish here, so what do you call a good fish here?
A trophy, you're looking 30 pound or better.
Holy cow, what a pig.
All right,
we got a big one in the boat already.
That one'll be 25.
What is it, Mike?
It's right about 27, it's between 26 and 27.
Man.
He's making a mess.
A fish. Way to go, Mike.
Well, thank you. It's just fishing.
Well, I guess you catch and release mostly on your big ones?
I try to. If it's just me, clients, they like to keep them. You can eat a fish this size. I've cleaned a lot of them, but I'd like to let this one go.
Absolutely. Yeah. Let's do that.
That'd be one more for the folks that come fishing with me. When you throw these big ones back, you want to aim them kind of down so they're not disoriented.
There he goes, straight down, she goes. We're just out in open water. We're in 80, 90, 100 feet of water out here, and already got a great big one on camera. That's a start for you, and let's get you started with fishing and lake reports from close to you.
Hi folks, this week's Lone Star Lakes is brought to you once again by Ulrich Cabins. Family owned, Texas based, Ulrich Cabins stands ready to build your ranch lodge on your property, your fishing cabin by the lake, or just a weekend place where the family can relax, dream, and enjoy. Be sure and check out mytexascabin.com or call the phone number on your screen to get the special discount offer for our Lone Star Lakes viewers. Now this week we're going to go to Lake Palestine in East Texas, where the lake itself has a great topwater bite, specifically the frog bite. You can use the hollow body frogs or the solid rubber frogs. Throw those in and around the inundated timber and vegetation on the northwestern end of the lake and you'll get a good bite. Good colors include the greens and blues, the frog spotted colors, of course, and if you're using the rubber frogs, put a little chartreuse dye on both of the feet. Now, on the Natchez, which feeds Palestine up above the lake, just outside Tyler, Parks and Wildlife has a new public access area. It features not only a boat ramp and kayak launch, but about a half mile of shoreline bank fishing previously unavailable to anglers, and you can take advantage of that for the white bass run. Use your smaller baits in your topwaters and your spinner baits or things like the Roadrunner to catch these sand bass before the run plays out near the end of the month and the fish start to move back toward the main lake. That's this week's Lone Star Lakes, brought to you once again by Ulrich Cabins. Be sure and check out mytexascabin.com for your special Lone Star Lakes viewers discount offers. Now let's check in with Mr. Bill Olson. He's on the coast.
Hi folks, Texas Outdoors Journal brings you this week's report, and our April issue is now on sale on newsstands with some timely tips for some great fresh and saltwater fishing and the exciting spring turkey season. These are a few examples of why Texas Outdoors Journal has been named the number one major outdoor magazine in Texas for 19 years. Pick up a copy on newsstands or subscribe at texasoutdoorsjournal.com or call 800-222-4TOJ. Well, let it blow, let it blow, let it blow. A fairly typical refrain this time of year for Texas coastal anglers. On the upper Texas coast, winds above 12 to 15 miles per hour will stir waters and turn them off color. Now use this to your advantage by fishing color lines. Use bright or dark colored baits and use fish attractors like a popping cork or mauler. Where to fish is equally important. Fishing the backside of barrier islands, spoil islands along the intercoastal waterway, shallow marshes or lakes afford protection from the wind. On the middle and lower coast, higher winds can be withstood as grass beds prevent the water from becoming as off-colored. Those grassy areas and beds also help dissipate sand particles, clearing the water when the winds lay at night. Get a chart, monitor forecast, and make a plan to deal with the wind. This weekend, Saturday, has a double tide schedule of two high and two low tides. This Sunday has a single tide schedule of one high and one low. I'm Bill Olson, and I'll see you on the coast.
There we go. Big old Beaver Lake striper right there. I got a bite. I got a bite on a shad, shiner. Got him, fish on. All right, we got one on. Come on, baby. Oh, that's a good fish, that's a good pull. Loosen my drag, let him run a little. All right, let me tell you this story. Welcome back, everybody. We're on Beaver Lake, and we're out here with Mike Bailey, who's with Beaver Safari Guide Service. And a strange thing happened. We were just driving down the lake and Mike stopped and looked in a cove and there were a bunch of birds way in the back of the cove, real shallow, literally up in like 3-4 feet of water. And sure enough, these stripers had these shad pinned up way back here in the back of a cove. I'm gonna step back here behind you. The cool thing about these nitros is they've got these net holders back here that keep the net completely out of the way until you need it. I've got a great rod for doing this. This is the David Fritz Perfect Crankbait Rod Luz makes. and it's got a lot of flex to it. It's made for throwing crankbaits for bass, but it's perfect for catching stripers. Easy, darling. Easy, darling. Turn this way, baby. Her head needs to go in this net. I've got to get her turned. I got her. Oh, wow. Look at this. Oh, my gosh. Man, look at that. What an awesome fish. That is truly amazing. Truly, absolutely amazing. Well, I had to take my jacket off. I've about worked a sweat up here. What a great fish. We'll show it to you one more time. There we go. Big old Beaver Lake striper right there. We're going to take you now to fishing and lake, saltwater and freshwater reports from right in your backyard. What a fish, what a day.
Hey friends, Captain Kevin Broussard here for your Fox Sports Louisiana Outdoor Report. We're talking saltwater fishing. Tell you what, Captain Carlos went out today, caught a nice box of trout. He today started off soft plastics on eighth and quarter ounce Rockport Rattler jig heads. Then they went to some live shrimp under some polychlorine. They were fishing the very north part of the bay system. Tell you what, they caught some really quality trout. Right now, on the whole Gulf Coast in Louisiana, fishing's picking up. You're starting to get into that late springtime, early summertime pattern. Lots of trout, few redfish showing up. I tell you what, the main thing is, get out and get on the water. For Cajun Phil, I'm Captain Kevin Broussard, saying happy fishing and may God bless you.
Hey everybody, we literally just pulled up on Mike from Catching My Fish. And Mike was fighting one just outside the mouth of the cove. Wow, this one's even bigger than the one we just released. Good night, look at this fish, baby.
29 and a quarter.
Goodness, 29 and a quarter, nearly a 30 pound striped bass right there. Give us one more mug shot and put her back.
If she was full of eggs and spawn ready to go, that'd be a 32, 33 pound fish right there.
What a fish. All right, I'm gonna push back and you can put her back right here in front of us. All right. What's the principle behind the little bitty small hooks?
It's fishing that clear water. It's finesse fishing is what it is. Just like you're finesse bass fishing, we're finesse striper fishing.
Look how clear this water is too. Man, you can see way down.
Oh, she's tired. Come on.
All right, we've got big fish working in here today. Let's take a quick break for word from our sponsors and we'll be back to Beaver Lake, Arkansas, home of the giant stripers right after this. There she goes, straight down. Wow.
Nice. I love it.
What a great deal, man. Way to go.
Fox Sports Outdoors is brought to you by Lewes. Fueled by passion, driven by innovation. Feel the difference. Gene LaRue Bass Baits and Bobby Garland Crappie Baits, the leaders in soft plastic lures innovation. And Nitro Performance Fishing Boats. Champions aren't born, they're made.
I don't even know if this fish will go in the net or not. I got him. Oh my gosh, what have I done? Hey everybody, we're on one of the most scenic lakes in the state of Arkansas today. This is beautiful Beaver Lake, located just outside Springdale. We're just using the Motor Guide XI5 trolling motor to ease us along, and I'm pulling some live shiners behind the boat. No weight, just on an open hook, free lining they call it. And I'm just slow trolling down about 10 to 15 feet of water where these stripers are just migrating up and down these sandbars and see if we can get bit. There's a bite. There goes one. He's got it, he's got it, he's got it, he's got it, got him. Oh my gosh, hold on. He's stripping drag, stripping drag. This is absolutely finesse fishing at its finest. You gotta downsize your line, downsize your hook, downsize your bait. Everything's gotta be downsized. I've got 14 pound test fluorocarbon line on here. I've got my real flexible rod here. I lose David Fritz perfect cranking rod. And I'm adjusting the drag on my BB2 Pro reel. But I feel like he's starting to get close a little bit. Beast. This is a beast right here. This is a pig. I don't even know if this fish will go in the net or not. I got him. Oh my gosh. What have I done? Oh, I can't even lift it. Oh man, look at this. Oh man. This is the biggest striper I've maybe ever, well, it's not the biggest striper I ever caught. I caught a 50 pound 4 ouncer in New Mexico one time. But this is certainly the biggest one short of that. Man. Look at this. And we are gonna release this fish back. This is a whale. We've got a, I can't even, oh my gosh. There she wants to go. There she goes. All right. We did it. Kept her alive. Okay, here's what I'm gonna do. Didn't have a scale that big, but Mike Bailey's got a formula, and I did take some measurements on the fish, and I got the length and the girth around the biggest part of the fish. So we're gonna put right now up on the screen, since we can edit after the fact and tell you roughly what this fish weighed. And we're gonna get you some fishing and lake reports. And I'm just gonna, I'm gonna try to catch my breath and take a heart pill.
Well, here we are again at that crazy time in spring where the fishing can change constantly throughout any given day. And those conditions can change according to wind velocity and direction, how much sunlight you have, and whether or not the water is coming up or going down. And the most consistent lake here in the state that I continue to get reports on over the past several weeks is Lake Tenkiller. The bass fishing has been really good on that lower third of the lake. Main lake flat points coming out pretty far from the shoreline. That means staying in about 2 to 8 foot of water out several yards away from the shoreline. Look for those transition shorelines that have rock, either flat or softball to basketball size, that transition into something else, either clay or the pea gravel banks. Those points along those transition areas are doing really well right now on the biffle bug rigged on 11/16 ounce hardhead. You want to keep that bait bouncing along the bottom, deflecting off as you reel it back pretty quickly. Most consistent crappie fishing continues to be Lake Eufaula. You can catch them there on the Bobby Garland 3-inch slab slayer, 1/8 ounce jig head, electric chicken color, doing really well regardless of the watercolor part of the lake that you're on. Again, concentrate in those 2 to 8 foot depths. Keep that bait bouncing right on the bottom in those stretches. Those fish are moving along close to the bottom, especially along those transition zones, break lines in front of the spawning coves, the spawning flats. Great time of year to be fishing in Oklahoma. Get those kids on the water, and remember, you can't catch them if you don't go.
Be sure to join Fox Sports Outdoors again next week, Thursday at 5:30, or catch the repeat airing Saturday morning at 8. And you can always watch the latest episode in full HD on the front page of our website at foxsportsoutdoors.com. Plus, catch up on all past episodes by clicking the archive button. And see lots of our how-to and product videos by selecting the how-to button. Join our online fishing community. Just click the like button on our Facebook page for access to daily posts with lots of fishing news, videos, and frequent giveaways. And stay up to date with all the latest fishing information and photos by following our Twitter feed. Fox Sports Outdoors is brought to you by Motor Guide Trolling Motors. Motor Guide, because accuracy matters. Academy Sports and Outdoors, right stuff, low price, every day. And Exide Technologies, powering the world forward.
Welcome back, everyone. Let's get right to your Ask the Pro question for this week. Kyler wants to know, are crappies strictly a brush pile fish? For the answer, we asked Chris Lindenberg of Gene LaRue and Bobby Garland Lures.
Most people do believe there's usually a couple of places that crappie hang out. One is docks. The other is any kind of structure like timber and brush piles. And the other is ledges. We go for break, creek breaks. But that's not really where they are most of the time. Most of the time, they're in open water, and they're following balls of shad, and they're going to continue to follow those balls of forage fish, which are mostly shad. And whether they move into coves and creeks, they'll move in there with them, and they'll stay in there as a school. Especially in the winter time, they really gang up in the middle, but you have to go in with the electronics we have now, you can actually find those balls of shad and you can see those schools of crappie with them. And I guarantee you, just hold on when you get on top of them because you can load the boat.
Thanks, Chris. If you want some help from one of the pros, go to foxsportsoutdoors.com and follow the Ask the Pro link to submit a question. Now it's time for the Costa Catch of the Week, where someone wins a new pair of sunglasses.
Hey everybody, it's time for this week's winner in the Costa Catch of the Week contest. It's Blair Parsley of San Angelo, Texas, showing a 13-pound largemouth bass caught at Twin Buttes Lake in West Texas on a drop shot rig.
If you'd like to be our next winner, just go to our website at foxsportsoutdoors.com, click in the Costa Catch of the Week area on the front page, follow the instructions to send us your photo, and you just might be our next winner. And if you'd like to see all of the Costa frame and lens styles, go back to the front page of our site, click on the Costa logo, and you'll see all of the frame styles and lens styles that Costa offers.
The gear we use to catch all these stripers today really is pretty simple. This is the Lewes Speed Stick David Fritz Perfect Crankbait Rod. It's actually a bass rod. Did a great job catching those stripers all the way up to a 44-pounder on this rod, but the real key is the reel. This is the Lewes Speed Spool Super Duty reel. It's made for horsing in these big giant fish like this big 44-pound striper we caught today. Light monofilament line, only 14-pound test, and there's that little bitty tiny bait hook that we use to catch every striper today. Your vocabulary word for the day is legacy. It means what you leave behind when you leave planet Earth. Needless to say, you and I won't be living in these bodies forever. And when we exit, will you just leave your favorite shotgun, your favorite fishing rod, some property, or some money to your heirs? Or will you leave something much more important? What will people say about you when you're gone? What will your kids say? Remember, it's not what you take when you leave this world, it's what you leave behind that's important. I'd like to give you the contact information one more time for Mike Bailey's guide service in case you'd like to come book a trip here and catch yourself a big old striper like the one we caught today. Once again, I gotta give you another look at that fish. It was 29 inches around. We ran it through a formula. Approximately 44 pounds, one of the top thrills of my fishing life. Hey, before we get out of here, two more quick things. First of all, the search bar on our archives page, that's really important. We've got hundreds and hundreds of videos there, past episodes, how-to videos, product videos. You can search through those very easily by just typing the term you're looking for in that search bar and that video will pop up. Secondly, we're going live on Facebook after many of our episodes this season. So right now, jump over on Facebook at our Fox Sports Outdoors page. See if we're going live tonight. If so, you can ask us any question you'd like and I'll answer those questions live, including any question you want to know about Beaver Lake. From Northwest Arkansas, until next week, I'm Barry Stokes. Be safe, have fun. Bye-bye, y'all.